work with them. You don't want to work with those kind of people. You know, they don't really pay, but it's more for the experience. So, and I'm returning home this summer, and I'm like, what do I do in that situation? Should I reach out and say, you know, I'm willing to still help, but...
Did you say something about immoral?
Yeah, like an immoral, they have an immoral, it's
there's
like an immoral standpoint on that.
Okay. Yeah, because if not for that piece, you know, and it was just about the should you be working for free piece, I would say that like these are the years to be willing to do a little bit of work for free. There comes a point where I think you say, okay, should I be doing work for free? But if it's not interfering with jobs that do make you money and personal responsibilities that you have there, or personal responsibilities you have in school and in your classes, then I say go for it. But on the other piece, you know, I guess it depends. I guess you have to dig into that a little bit more and see if it's something that you would feel very comfortable with, you know, sharing with others, say in an interview, like you want to be able to talk confidently about that company and that experience without feeling like you have to hide a piece of it. So since you did do some work with them, you know, maybe there's enough skill there now to find something with a company you can truly be excited about and believe in.
It wasn't clear to me, what was the exact job that you applied for at IBM? How did you find that job, and what was that relationship or connection that you actually had for IBM?
So I found the job on Twitter, and I had been looking at IBM because I wanted to work in a tech company, and they hired remotely, and I liked some of these this work they were doing around culture and people, and so that job, compared to some of the others I had seen on the IBM jobs website, I thought it matched my skill set a little more, so I was really excited about it, and because of that, I, you know, dug into who was doing the hiring a little bit, which I found through the Twitter post, and then I connected with him on LinkedIn, sent him a message there, and he was very responsive, and it took a little bit of time. I didn't hear from him for several weeks because he was following a couple of internal leads, because like I said, usually they go with internal hires. But that was how I did it.
So what was the job that I mean, from your background in music, what was it that caught your attention?
Well, it was the storytelling aspect.
The storytelling.
Yeah, and I knew that, you know, if I was going to be in the business world, I wanted to bring in something like that that felt a little bit more human, and it tied back to the writing and communication pieces that I knew I could work with. Anybody else? Yeah.
I have one. Okay, so I have a sneaking suspicion that yoga helps with this because, yes, it does. But I'm curious if you do future casts, and I just did it in my head, and I think she would say, hopefully she has totally white hair, but I think she'd say back, Chandra, chill out. So how do you balance the piece for young women of like, chill out, it's okay, with stay hungry, lean in, go after it, fight for what you want. Do you have, other than yoga, because that's really important, do you have other beginning strategies for that balance of chill but go hard?
That's hard. And in my 20s, I was not so great at that. And that's why looking back, I see more opportunities for kind of taking things in stride. And somehow I've gotten better at it as I look at what might be next in my career and kind of think about what are the things that I really love that I want to be part of my work and part of every single day. And as I look at how to, you know, make that happen, I feel a lot calmer about it's going to work out. It's I can trust that it's going to land in a good place. I don't have to feel like I'm fighting for my life. I'm not sure that I have a perfect answer, but I would say that it probably is somewhere along the lines of, you know, making sure that you take time for yourself to do those things that make you feel joy, whether it's reading or yoga or singing, and by sort of focusing on the present moment. And I think there's this great quote, I think, relating to meditation that is basically like, if you're thinking about the past, it's depression. If you're thinking about the future, it's anxiety. If you're living in the present, everything is wonderful. And it can be very hard just to be comfortable and confident in the moment that is here and now. But I think just focusing on that and finding ways to be comfortable with where you are can be valuable. But it's work. I mean, it's not, there's no like perfect equation. actually fun because there's a lot less pressure than I had with these opera auditions in New York and Philadelphia and things that could be very stressful. And my husband plays the piano. It's very convenient. So he can accompany me. And I had a birthday a few weeks ago, and he got me a ukulele because he knew that I wanted to learn to play an instrument and maybe even sing with it. I've never played a string instrument, so I've got some. It's going to be an uphill climb. But yeah, so there are ways. And I know singers who are still very involved with church choirs and things. That, I mean, I had church choir jobs in grad school, but it's not my love, so I don't do that. But that's another way. Community choirs, local opera, choruses, things like that.
I just want to make sure you get the material.
Yeah, thank you. A lot of people have said that. And, you know, I'm not singing classically. I might at some point, who knows. But it would take a lot of retraining to kind of get up where I was. So, you know, maybe at some point.
What did you do in governor's school?
A voice as well. I studied voice there, and then I went back to work there in the outreach department. And so I traveled around the state and told kids about the program. I helped the music department specifically with recruiting and finding students, and so I had a good time. Anybody else?
Thank you, Lauren. Everybody, by this point, you know the drill with the blogs. The assignment will be up later today, and it will be much like the others. So you just write a couple hundred words by Wednesday.